we'll be studying about elements of circulation, and at the end I would be giving a specific explanation of how circulation is observed in a residence. So, talking about circulation, we must know what circulation actually is. These are the routes or the pathways that people take through and around the spaces. Whether we need to enter a space or move around a space, the paths that we use are known as circulation. And circulation is often thought of space between spaces, because we already have a bigger space, but to move in or around it, we need a space. So that is why it is known as space between the spaces. And they have a connective function, because from one place to another, inside a building, inside a built place, we need to move around it, move from one room to another room. The path that we use is known as the circulation space. So it has a connective function ke ek room se dusre room mein connect ho raha hai. It is a concept that captures the experiment of moving our bodies around a building three-dimensionally and through the time. Obviously, per unit time we are moving 3D, so circulation. Components of circulation: it is direction of movement. Either we could move vertically or horizontally. Then for what purpose it is being used, whether it is public or private, or at the back of the house or at the front of the house. Then we have how common we use it, how often we use the space, if it is used very commonly or it is used for just the emergency purposes. Then the timing of use, whether it is used at the day or night or the morning, evening, or continuously throughout the time period it is being used. Coming on to the elements. First is the building approach. How easy the building can be viewed from the distance. The next is building entrance. How we go outside of the building to the inside. Next is configuration of path. In what sequence or what pattern the paths are arranged. Then the path and the space relationship, whether they are related at the edges or nodes, whether they are connecting at the terminal or what. Then what form of the circulation space is. It is either corridor, balcony, gallery, or anything. We'll be studying about all these elements in detail. First is building approach. A frontal approach, as you can see in the first picture, we have a very straight path, a very straight axis, a line that is directly leading into the door, that directly leads us into that space. That is known as the frontal approach. Then next we have a perspective. The perspective enhances the effect. How we view it from a distance, it is not directly viewed as the frontal approach. We view it from a perspective, unlike the front. Cannot enter it directly. And then the next is our spiral path. The spiral path prolongs the sequence of the approach, and apart from that, it emphasizes the three-dimensional form of the building that it moves around the building's perimeter. We cannot go directly into the building. We have to go straight, take a complete 3D, 360 degree around path, then enter the building. It is not always 360, it might be some rotation at an angle. That is what is known as a spiral path. And the main thing about the spiral path is that it takes a longer time for the person to enter into a space. Then coming on to building entrances. entrance is a vertical plane that distinguishes one space from another and separates here from there. It separates from what a space is from the other space. It differentiates, basically, in simpler words. So entrances can be either flush entrance, projected entrance, or recessed entrances. These are the three main type of entrances that we have. Coming on to what flush entrance is, it is the simple sort of entry where we have the continuity of the wall surface and it may or may not be obscured, or sometimes it is on purpose obscured. Then we have projected entrances. Projected entrances sort of provide function of giving a shelter overhead. For example, we have at our entries or our main gates, we have projected entrances. Projected entrances announce their function to provide shelter overhead. They provide a sense of comfort and shelter overhead. Then we have recessed entrances, which also have the function of providing shelter, and also they bring in a portion of exterior space into so path space relationship. There are three types of spaces: pass by spaces. So the pass by spaces is the type of space through which you move from one space to reach to another space. For example, supposedly here is my kitchen area. I have my dining area over here and here is my living room. So I have a foyer here, or just say I'm coming from this area. I move from here. This is my kitchen area. I pass through the living room. I pass through the dining room to reach into this space. That is kitchen. So I am passing these two spaces, but I'm not disturbing any of its function. So the individuality of the each space here is maintained. The configuration of the path is flexible. I can easily go from the two spaces to reach my specific destination. And the mediating spaces. Here, this space is used to link the path with the specific space. Coming on to what a pass through space is. This path may pass through a space axially, obliquely, or along its edge. Supposedly, I have my... let's just take it as an example. I have my drawing room over here. And I have my dining room here. There's no outer space of linkage. So my entry to drawing room is here and I'm going into the living area from its side to reach the dining area. So I am passing through one space to another space. That leads me to a new space. Then what are terminating spaces? For terminating spaces, supposedly these are the rooms. I have a corridor where I have various rooms moving from the here, this area to this end. So now I have a dead end here, and I suppose this is some hospital corridor with wards
opposing, and I place a spiritual corner over here. So now the terminating spaces are like those. It's like a location which establishes its path by itself. Now I have this terminating space because there was an existing space. मतलब अगर हमारे पास दूसरी space यानी कि ये entries and doors या ये spiritual spot ना होता तो I would not move from this space to this space. Obviously मैं यहाँ से यहाँ पे जब मेरी entry सिर्फ यहाँ पे और यहाँ पे है अब I go to this area. Why would okay, I'm sorry. Yeah, this was my spiritual spot जहाँ पे मैं hospital के कहीं corridor में मैं कोई statue place कर रही हूँ and I have my rooms over here. Here is another door and another door here. Why would I go to this area when my purpose is solved here? So, this is a terminal point that establishes its own path because if it wouldn't have been here, there would be no purpose of going. A space relationship is used to approach and further it acts as a functionally or symbolically important space. As explained. So now what configuration of the path is? We have various types of paths. It could be linear, radial, spiral, grid, network, or even the composite path. So what a linear path is? Supposedly, we basically linear means something straight. We can have a line. We can have entry from here, here, door, here, or here, as explained in this picture. Or we could have it in a straight line. We have a space over here and a space over here. Then radial path. Radial is something circular from a central point. Various paths are originating. As we can see in this picture, we have this central point. And all the other spaces are being connected through this common spot throughout. This is our common spot. All the other spaces here are being connected through it. So spiral path, it has a single continuous path first. It originates from a specific central point and then it revolves around it. We here can see this is a spiral. We have a originating point, then all the parallel lines are rotating around it. Then grid, it is like parallel set of paths jo regular intervals pe ek dusre ko intersect karte hain, usually at 90 degrees. Then network, random paths are connected at a specific space. And a composite path, there abhi jitni bhi humne configurations padhi, whether it's spiral, radial, linear, all the mixture of these spaces creates a composite configuration. It could be like we have a linear space, two spaces are being connected, then we take up a central point. Then we connect spaces radially to it, or even we may choose something that intersects this radial. So this is what we call composite space. So coming on to horizontal circulation, simpler words are hallways, atrias, paths, entries, exits. These are all included in horizontal spaces. All the doors, porches, foyers, balconies, lobbies, the connecting basic spaces of our home, which connects private areas to the public areas or semi-public areas, are known as horizontal circulation. Just a basic rough idea. So it may be affected by how we place our furniture. Supposedly we are going through a straight line, but I place a beam or a column in the middle of it, so it acts as an obstruction. Beech mein I'm moving and beech mein kuch aa jata hai, I couldn't go further. So it acts as an obstruction. Or if I'm moving straight and there's a sofa piece laying all over there, I couldn't move further from that space straight. So there are various obstructions sometimes in circulation, in horizontal circulation. So maybe it could be a furniture layout or columns or even trees or any topographic changes. Even there might be, like, I'm moving in some hilly area, I would be going straight and I have a mountain, I'm going straight through on a straight road and there's a mountain in between, I couldn't go further. That's the end of the space. So the horizontal circulation ends over there. So it may create issues of visibility or how crowds move, and escape paths usually are clear in horizontal circulation. Here we have hallways. This is our living area, and this is, here is the path hallway, which is included in horizontal circulation. Then we have foyers. We have, this is, see this area, highlighting this area. This is our main entry, and coming into the house, this is our horizontal circulation. We have lobbies. See this path further connects into this room, whatever this space may be, and towards here. And then we have porch, the entrance area. You may enter the home from coming to circulation vertically. How we move up and down through the space, very simple terms used. This is known as vertical circulation. So obviously we know, till now it even might be clear, that all the stairs, ramps, ladders, whatever you consider to move up or down three-dimensionally, that allows us to move from one place to another or one level to another level, is known as vertical circulation, as stairs, ramps, everything. So here, considering the example of a residence, see, we have this plan. This is the main entry. Here, this is the main gate. We have horizontal circulation over here. While entering the gate, we have a few steps or a small ramp which acts as a vertical circulation. Then coming into, this is the lobby area, which is again a form of a horizontal circulation. The stairs which leads to the second floor of the building, here is a vertical circulation. Then we have two bedrooms and even the OTS here, even the OTS above. And here we have free area, OTS is on the second floor. So down area, here it is free, it is left out for ventilation. Even it, we could connect spaces through that free area. So that, it's all clear to you. Thank you.
Don't forget to subscribe, like, and comment on this video. If any of your queries are not cleared, please mention in the comments so that I could clear it out. And yeah, like, subscribe to Noble Crew Tutors. Thank you.